Okay, you all know how 3D printing works. You start out by creating a 3D model, export that as an STL or 3MF, then input that into your slicer, which then creates the G-code that the printer understands. Except that it doesn't have to be that way. Enter full control G-code. This is actually the result of a research paper by Dr. Andrew Gleadall, and it lets you skip modeling and slicing, and instead provides you with a scripting interface that controls every single printer move. You get full control, and that lets you do some incredible stuff that would be nearly impossible to model first, but it also allows you to specifically optimize and craft functional parts to make maximum use of the specialties of filament-based printing. This part is a battery mounting tray that I need to make 24 of, and I managed to get it down from 2 hours of printing all the way down to just 30 minutes with a functionally identical version crafted in full control G-code. And that is without cranking up the print speed. So let's check out full control G-code, what it does, how it works, and what you can't quite do with it yet. Right after we check out today's sponsor, Private Internet Access. Look, there are plenty of VPN services around, but this is the one that I actually personally use. A while ago, I compared VPN providers, and Private Internet Access ended up being the one that checked all the boxes for features like port forwarding, a no-lock policy, and fast servers without throttling or filtering, while also being one of the most affordable options. Their client is open source, but you can use any of your own OpenVPN or WireGuard compatible clients as well. Private Internet Access has servers in over 75 countries, so when I want to experience the internet from the great country of Kazakhstan, I can. Also works with any of your favorite streaming services. You can use a single Private Internet Access subscription with up to 10 different devices at the same time, and when you sign up for the 3-year plan, I did, it comes out to less than $2 a month. Plus, if you use this link, also down in the description below, you get an extra 2 months for free. You don't get those if you don't use the link. They have 24/7 live chat support, and you can try them risk-free with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Thanks again to Private Internet Access for sponsoring this video. Back to you, Steve. If anyone ever tells you, you need to learn how to work with spreadsheets, and you just go, boring, don't. Knowing even some basic spreadsheet stuff has come in handy for me so many times already, and in the case of Full Control G-code, it's actually the only thing running the show. Full Control G-code is written entirely in Microsoft Excel and its Visual Basic macro function. I signed up for the Microsoft Office 30-day trial because this does absolutely not run in the free LibreOffice or in Google Docs. So basically, you just download the Full Control G-code Excel sheet, open it up, enable macros, and you're off to the races. Now, the closest thing this reminds me of is programming a CNC, like a proper industrial CNC, using the built-in features of something like a Heidenheim controller. But in the case of Full Control G-code, you don't need to know any actual G-code to use it, because the generation of that G-code itself all happens based on the features you set up. So let's start out with the simplest example. Let's make a line. What it needs is the start position, end position, and how wide and tall your extruded track should be. Full Control G-code automatically calculates how much filament should be extruded for that, and if you paste the generated G-code into RepetierHost, there's our line. I usually don't use RepetierHost much, but because Full Control G-code delivers the generated G-code by copying it into the clipboard, being able to just paste it right into RepetierHost is perfect for previewing what it's doing. Now, of course, just generating a line isn't anything special. You could just as well do that by typing out the G-code by hand. What's not so easy to type out is arcs and circles. In Full Control G-code, that's just another feature. You set the origin, the radius, and where your circle should start and end, and that's it. All the math happens in the background. The real power move, though, is being able to use any mathematical function. In fact, any function that Excel supports for doing math inside of a cell to describe and to define your extrusion paths. So, for example, if you want to create a squiggly line, we say X just progresses linearly, but on Y we can use a sine function for the position and we get this. This is one of the most powerful ways of defining geometry that I've seen so far. And it doesn't end there. Probably the most useful feature in here is that it can create repeats, so an array of the same feature. Let me show you that with the battery tray as an example, because this is basically just 80 copies of the same geometry. So of course, the main thing is a circle. which I'm copying 9 additional times along X, then I'm copying the original circle and the 9 copies along Y another 7 times, and then to give it some height, all that gets copied another 25 times along the Z-axis. And of course, the order that we're copying in does matter. If you first copied along Z and then along X and Y, the printer would print one full circle and then crash as it tries to print the next one right beside it. The rest of the battery tray are 3 different types of rectangles underneath the cylinders that tie them together and create little lips to keep the cells from just falling through. Because full control G-code knows nothing about infill patterns, I created each rectangle feature 3 times and inset it a bit each time. So, why is this print so much faster than the traditionally sliced one? Optimization and cutting out everything that isn't absolutely necessary. The bulk of the print time is taken up by the actual cylindrical cell holder part. And for the print done with full control G-code, all that needs to be printed is one single cylinder move. But if we look over to the slice part, yeah, we have the same perimeter that's being printed, but then you always also need a second perimeter on the other side. And where the circles from 2 adjacent positions overlap, you always get some weirdness where they meet. And what really slows down the prints is all these tiny little gap infill bits that the printer needs to do to perfectly reproduce the part. Sure, you could model your part perfectly to work with the thin wall printing feature or turn off infill altogether, but that can cause some real nasty problems elsewhere. What I've also done with the full control G-code version of the part is that I reduced the number of faces that the circles are being generated with. That doesn't help with print speed, but it does automatically create a nice spring-loaded grab on the cells. And I've also aligned the printing direction and the start-stop points of each circle towards the top so that the printer can smoothly move from one circle to the next, and it avoids crossing over the inside of each circle, which means it doesn't even need to retract on the way, and it also allows it to keep its velocity going from one circle to the next. That is nearly impossible to do this cleanly in a traditional slicer. And of course, it doesn't end there. Remember how I showed you how full control G-code lets you use any mathematical formula to calculate your toolpaths? Well, that doesn't just work in X and Y, it also works for Z, in 2 ways. First, you can use Z as a parameter for how each layer's toolpath gets printed. So this print is just one line in full control G-code, but it uses the current nozzle height as a variable too. So with each layer, the way that the toolpath gets calculated is slowly changing and it morphs into different shapes as it moves up. Also, this is a vase mode print. It's actually just one long move where I'm slowly increasing the Z value. For playing around with what sorts of shapes you can generate without having to fully generate them in full control G-code every time, Dr. Andrew Glido has shown that you can use the web-based tool Desmos for that, and it does work really well. You just have to then translate the functions you found from the clean formula representation in Desmos to the somewhat convoluted Excel format. So the other thing you can do with the Z-axis is, of course, non-planar slicing. The Z-axis position is just another variable that you can leave static for each layer, or just like X and Y, fill with whatever functions your heart desires, as long as your printer can handle it, of course. I don't have one of those super long and pointy airbrush nozzles at hand, so I'm kind of limited in how steep and how tall I can go in each layer, but still, I managed to print these 2 parts. One that does little Z-hop bridges over free air, which I guess might work better with PLA instead of PTG, and with a bit more optimized print settings. And the other one, again using the vase mode trick and a periodic variation on the Z height that fades in over the first couple of layers. The effect is a lot more dramatic in the preview, but being able to manipulate how the Z axis moves during each printing move is one of those things that will come in incredibly handy at some point. And the list of features in full control G-code goes on. Instead of using Cartesian, you know, X, Y coordinates, you can use radial coordinates, where you use angle and radius to define positions, and then after 360 degrees, you're back at the start, which is great for anything that is round, really, you know, vases and such, for example. This lampshade generator is one of the most popular use cases of full control G-code, and you can get a huge range of patterns out of it by changing the settings around just a bit. You can also add modifier features to previous features. You can do mirror patterns, circular ones. You can use parameters to define your entire design. The possibilities are endless. Almost. Because there are still some fairly severe limitations to full Control GCode. First of all, it's pretty slow because it does run in Excel. This lampshade takes about 6 or 7 minutes to process, which means for any changes you're trying out, you're going to have to wait that long before you can see what your changes actually did. And then there's no way to say, for example, exclude this region. So when you need some sort of a cutout or space for an insert or another part to mate into, you're going to have to craft your code around that from the start. Now, I don't blame you if you're kind of going, okay, but how is this useful? The thing is, full Control GCode is a tool like anything else, and by itself, it doesn't do all that much. Sure, there are a couple of really cool examples like the lampshade generator that you can play around with and create some interesting shapes with, but as with any tool, it's most useful when you start to wrap your head around how full Control GCode works and your brain starts making those connections of, oh, I could design this in full Control GCode if I use that feature with this one, and so on. So what I would recommend is to check out the tutorial series by Dr. Andrew Glidal over on his channel. It doesn't cover all the features, but you get a really good idea of how full Control GCode can be used. And hey, it might just be something that can expand what you can do with your 3D printer. All the links that you need to get started are in the description below. Thank you for watching, keep on making, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!